The 64-year-old St. Louis Arena is the site for the Midwest Regionals as we get set to bring you the nightcap of today's doubleheader. Coming your way, it'll be this regional's surprise team, the six-seeded Golden Bears of California, taking on the number two seed, the Jayhawks of Kansas. And the winner will advance to Saturday's regional final to meet Indiana, a winner earlier this evening over Louisville by 13. And good evening, everyone. I'm James Brown. Well, the California Golden Bears have come crashing into this party of the Sweet 16 with a very young team and a young head coach. That head coach, 29-year-old Todd Bozeman, who took over the program under a cloud of controversy. The controversy, the midseason firing of then-coach Lou Campanelli, who had a record of 10-7. It upset many in the coaching ranks who thought maybe Bozeman had a hand in his demise. Bozeman was then the assistant. It incensed Bozeman, but what he's done is to take his frustrations out on the court because those accusations have proven baseless. My partner is Bill Raftery, and Bill, gosh, how incensed has he been? The team has rallied around. They've won 8 straight, and it's a young squad, as I mentioned, that's led by a very precocious kid by the name of Jason.
Well, when you got Jason Kidd, there's a lot to rally around. This is a youngster that doesn't only beat you with scoring. He gets other people involved, as you can see. Transition.
Transition.
As in transition. The ability to trail his guy. He's got great strength. He's got an understanding of where to present himself to steal the basketball. And here in the open floor, an unusual, a plethora of releases. He loves to keep his teammates happy, and he's done a lot of that of late.
All right, Bill, the youthful exuberance of California will run into the experience of Kansas, the number two seed. They've got a senior backcourt combination that's outstanding in Rex Walters and Adonis Jordan.
Well, Rex Walters has the ability to use the intricate screens to find the spot. He'll spot up for the jumper. He can use the dribble, but the guy that sets him up, Adonis Jordan, not Michael, but penetrates beautifully and runs this club. A guy that includes everybody in the offense.
All right, and with more on this pregame talk, let's check in with the third member, Leslie Visser.
JV, the players from Cal are known as the Todd Squad, and their leader is a little superstitious. Todd Bozeman is 11-1 at Cal. His only loss against UCLA, he sat on the bench, so you'll see him stand for all 40 minutes. Well, as for their star player, he's no kid anymore. Jason told me he bought one copy of Sports Illustrated, but he won't read it until they beat Kansas. JV, I heard you and Rapper next week's cover.
Oh, my goodness. A circulation of about 2. As we take a look at the starting lineups, and Bill, again, anything to point out there matchup-wise?
Well, it's Kidd, I think, and how he controls the offense, and if Walters is the guy that he's guarding, making sure he doesn't get free for those spot-up jumpers.
Jim Burr out of Albany, New York, Larry Limbo out of Farmingdale, New York, and Gary Markham out of Nashville, Tennessee, the officials. Roberts of Cal quickly ahead to Murray, and the Bears are on the board quickly.
Cal, man-to-man. Pressure. Do a nice job assisting when necessary. Hawley, pretty good scorer.
Eric Hawley averages 12 on the season. We've got a tie ball game in the early going, 2 apiece. This is Jason Kidd being defended by Adonis Jordan.
And Kansas needs points off turnovers. That's the key to them. Then their secondary break.
Well, there's a turnover there for Cal as we take a look at the team profile. 21-8, the mark. First round victory over LSU, then the big one in the second round over two-time defending champion Duke. Walters with the ball for Kansas, operating on Kidd. No walk called on Hancock. The loose ball controlled by Cal. This is Jason Kidd.
Everybody runs because he gives it up.
Roberts, KJ Roberts off the front of the iron. Over the back, the foul is going to be called on Cal. And it's on Alfred Grigsby. As we take a look at the Kansas team profile, they started the season 16-1, finished up with a record of 27-6. Obviously out of the Big 8, they got here by beating Ball State and BYU.
Motion offense, Roy. A disciple of Dean Smith. Not bad territory to come from. You'll see a lot of screening, a little bit at Carolina and also Indiana.
by Hendrick on the inside. Brian Hendrick to the kid. And Grigsby couldn't control it, so it'll go back to Kansas. Bill, I tell you, it's been a while since you and I have been able to run up and down the court that fast, but would we have loved playing with a Jason Kidd?
You would get out. He finds the type of pass to deliver. Great ones do.
Look at this. Here comes Kidd.
Oh, hold on. The kid with a kick. You can't relax. Generally, he'll steal it off the bouncer when you put it up for grabs, but he can anticipate as well.
If you've not seen this kid play, you will enjoy him. Nice move on the inside for Kansas, and give it credit to Richard Scott. Nice turnaround move down low.
Step in the passing lane, acceleration, and just to think he may have been a soccer player. He loved Pele. Now it's magic, and good for us.
And speaking of magic, he cites Magic Johnson as the biggest influence on his game, Jason Kidd, that is. And Kidd kicks it back to Murray. Lamond Murray with the shot. A 6-4 Cal Golden Bears lead.
They do a nice job forcing the dribble and then throwing the ball back out. Inside screens and curl up the lane.
Good hands by Murray. Down low, strong move, no foul call, as Scott couldn't draw the foul. Here comes Kidd. And a holding foul is called on Adonis Jordan. Now, Bill, let's talk a little bit about Adonis Jordan, who at 5'11 is going to be operating with a bit of a handicap trying to defend against Kidd. He's got a stress fracture, the lower tibia, on that left leg of his.
Well, against Duke, Kidd did take Hurley down. They don't look for it. It takes them out of their offense.
Murray, long-range shot, rebounded.
There
stolen
he is.
By Kidd again. Second steal. Hendrick can't get the follow. And K.J. Roberts gets the loose ball.
On the basketball floor, this kid is a juvenile delinquent.
Steve Woodbury.
Pilferage, his middle name.
Woodbury, Scott, Hancock, Pauley. And Adonis Jordan, the 5 in white for Kansas on the floor.
Ball reversal.
And a foul called in the lane. It'll be on California. Called on Hendrick. And talk about some athletic genes. His father played here for the St. Louis Cardinals, of course.
World champs, 82. Across the street from the hotel. Can't even get in that part. On the out of bounds now. A lot of pop out to the corner. And watch Walters when he gets back in. He goes zone against it.
Calvin Rayford in for Kansas. Walters.
Great setup.
The words used to describe him, a gym rat.
He loves the game, and of course the transfer from Northwestern was because he felt he wanted to win and get to the NCAA. Spends all his time when not studying, bouncing the ball. Look at this double.
Stolen by Rayford, ahead to Walters. Nine-6 Jayhawks lead, and Roy Williams wasted no time in getting Calvin Rayford in at 5'9 to defend on Kidd, showing him different looks.
Some speed.
And Billy, I think I probably have given Rayford about 3 inches. He looks like about 5'6 to me.
Well, they do everything with Team Kansas. They like to double and assist. They get things off their turnover. It enables them generally to go the other way. Here, Rayford, you mentioned, I think you did an All-American game, the McDonald's All-American game, and Calvin got in trouble up there at the Hall of Fame. He tried to dunk, they talked him into it, tore the rim down at the Hall of Fame, and then they got out of the building, but the McDonald's people had to refund the Hall of Fame to fix the rim.
My mouth is hanging still. I can't believe
it. Can you believe that? That little guy getting up around the tin?
At 5'6", my goodness. Stevie Johnson in. For Cal. Three J.J. Roberts drops in the first, a 5'11 sophomore guard out of Kent, Washington. Moved into the starting lineup against Arizona at the Oakland Coliseum is where that game was played on March 4th, giving the coach a lot more quickness back there with Kidd.
And he's got some flexibility, too, with Gerard Hass, a terrific shooter and a guy that gives up his body getting up to get in right now. So, and they'll also play a little bit smaller on occasion.
Breaking the action, nip and tuck, try even at 9. Primetime NCAA tournament coverage coming your way tomorrow. George Washington against Michigan, Virginia and Cincinnati. And the doubleheader, Arkansas and North Carolina, Temple and Vanderbilt.
And that game, Nolan Richardson, a guy that's done a great job, that relentless pressure against Dean Smith. Those inside people have had a great year for him.
Woodbury with the miss, the rebound by Ryan Jameson.
Nice run.
A good run by Stevie Johnson.
It's contagious. Kid out. Play continues.
And for those who didn't follow the shorthand, Raftery was saying Jason Kidd out. But they're still running like he's in. And that basket is in by Richard Scott.
And JB, you notice how easily the ball's getting into the box for KU. They're going to have to make some adjustment, either three-quarter or step in front or double, and force the ball back outside and see if KU's on fire on those three-pointers. Can't get those easy opportunities.
Jared Hass, Lamond Murray, Ryan Jameson, Stevie Johnson, and KJ Roberts, the five in the blue uniforms for Cal. Ostertag with the nice block. Here comes Woodbury.
Ostertag down the floor looking to post up. They get it right to him.
Back inside, two-man basketball. Walters back inside, Ostertag, jump hook, short. Rebounded by Johnson. A long three by Murray.
He has a follow-through. When he knows he's nailed it, he lingers out there. But that's the problem when you push down the floor defensively. How do you go out and address the deep shooter? Walter's out late. He's tardy. But the size differential, you can't get up and negate the attempt.
And the size differential, as you mentioned, Murray at 6'7". Walters at 6'4".
Ostertag's got to have to make a strong move to the goal. That little hook. There's some strength, huh?
Walters tried a fancy behind-the-back pass to Darren Hancock to no avail. It goes over to Cal. To take a look at Roy Williams' fifth year at Kansas.
Well, there's the control and strength, but here's a guy zigging when he should have zagged. The communication level off.
Kidd back in the ball game for Cal. Jason Kidd, number five, with the ball, defended by Adonis Jordan. And Kidd quickly by him. Nowhere to go with that one. Good defense by KU.
Gets a hand on it, though.
Yes, indeed. Disrupting play again. Murray deep. Off the mark. Ostertag with the rebound.
Did you notice Kidd over in the passing lane?
Everywhere.
Good feel. What I like best, he gives it up early so a guy can do some damage.
Ostertag, Walters, Pat Ritchie, Hancock, and Jordan, the five in white for Kansas.
And Cal has not been hurt by the secondary break.
Todd Bozeman thought that Walters went up and down with it, but down goes the three from Jordan. A tie ball game again, 14 apiece, 12:44. Left in the first half. These two teams battling for the right to move into the Midwest Regional Final on Saturday against Indiana, which was a 13-point winner earlier over Louisville.
And James, you're looking at Roy Williams. I talked to some people in his conference about how to play them. They think they're very tough, Kansas, on teams who haven't seen them play. They're mixing defenses. Their ability to push the ball up the floor and getting some early offense can be disconcerting.
Well, Todd Bozeman certainly has seen a lot of him as Jordan comes up with the steal. And a foul called on Jason Kidd. That'll be personal foul number one. I was talking about Bozeman having seen Kansas play. The first thing he asked for when he checked in was get me a VCR. He had a bag full of tapes and he started to do his homework, and he has been doing his homework nicely since taking over.
This team has played great. You know, you and I addressed the Campanelli situation early in the year, and it's really a due process situation that upset us. This is a case, this man has been maligned by some coaches. Now they finally come out and said, hey, he was loyal. They didn't offer him the job. They asked him if he would take it without a promise of committing to him, and he's done a good job. Everybody I talked to in the California area said he was legit, honest, hardworking, and a situation where he's coaching because he recruited the kids, and it's worked out pretty well for him.
And Bozeman has been magnificent handling the pressure. Strong rebound and score the basket to Pauly. You see the double team on Kidd out high. Nice movement without the ball by Jamison, but blocked. Here come the Jayhawks.
Jamison lacking touch on that release. When you can get into the box that easily, you can spot people.
Walters.
Couple of hearts pumping out there on both ends of the floor.
Three.
Nice little ploy, doubling on the pick and roll, making Kidd give it up and others make decisions.
Pauly able to hit that outside shot, goes inside the pass, nearly went in. Jordan with the loose ball and score. Adonis Jordan. And here's a guy that's really been playing with some pain, and you saw him grimace that time getting up. Making him pay at the other end. Jared Hass.
Just get the feet set. He'll deliver.
Hass, a very emotional player who fires up the team with his play.
A little back screen's giving Cal some problems.
Boy, these shots. Okay. Seemingly no problem. Darren Hancock dropping it in.
Well, he's not known for that deep threat. He's a guy that can run the floor and finish.
While many people have not seen Jason Kidd play in person, Adonis Jordan and Rex Walters have. They played against him in high school when Kidd was a freshman. They were seniors.
Good balance by Cal.
...22-20. Jayhawks on top. 9:45 left and a half to play.
They got the offensive pick by Scott. You can't move, Richard. Stand still and set it.
Can't you follow number...
Kansas on top of California by two with 9:43 remaining in the first half of play. ...9:30 left in the first half of play. Kansas on top by the score of 22-20. James Brown along with Bill Raftery and Leslie Visser. And this is Cal with the ball. Jason Kidd.
They are a good passing team.
Yes, indeed.
Whipping good ball around.
Lamond Murray with the basket for Cal, averaging 18 points on the season. He's got 9 already.
Patrick.
Back screens in motion.
A lot of movement on the offense by Kansas. Woodbury, one of the Calvin best. Rayford, Patrick Ritchie.
Woodbury, one of the best 6 men in the country, JB.
That he is. Greg Gurley and Greg Ostertag, the 5 on the floor in white for Kansas. Under 10 on the shot clock. Rayford at 5'6", throwing it up to Ostertag now. Assist. He'll tell you it's a pass.
I think he was honing in, to be honest with you. But Greg in the right spot to finish it off.
Nearly stolen. Murray, nice running hook. Bill, you really like this guy.
I do. I heard Clark Kellogg talk about the long arms. He's got a high release point on his drives. He's got a great stroke deep. Gets to spots, knows how to get free.
And he's 4 of 8 from the floor. Ostertag, line drive, rebounded by Murray, stolen by Woodbury. To Gurley.
Extra pass, Kelvin.
Good defensive hustle, 1-on-2. Lamond Murray and Kidd tried to tightrope it, stepped out of bounds. Now, I tell you, the kid is tough, but walking along the tight line here.
Fancy footwork. His pursuit of the ball is extraordinary. He understands, gets after it. And right here, you got to have tiny toes, and he does.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
The St. Louis Arena, a building which has hosted some big NCAA games in years past. Right now, it's the Jayhawks and the Bears, both shooting very well from the floor. The backcourt of Kansas with 12 points between Adonis Jordan and Rex Walters, leading by one, 24-23, Kansas. Hendrick.
Ostertag doing a nice job holding off inside.
And Walters doing a nice job of dropping it in from the outside. 10 points for Rex Walters. He's got 15 points, and both teams battling for the opportunity to play Indiana on Saturday in the Midwest Regional Finals. Indiana advanced by beating Louisville by 13.
I mentioned Roy Williams being a Carolina disciple, Dean Smith. So the Carolina West, if you will. Mm-hmm. Doing a nice job fronting and create havoc in your patterns. You just don't have the normal look when you look to dump the ball down low. Somebody's back is in your face or a hand.
Kansas Jayhawks started the season 16-1. Wrapped up the season losing 5 of their last 14. Kidd. And here's Kidd getting his hand on the ball again. Jason Kidd tied for first in steals in the country, averaging nearly 4 a game. And Billy, when we talk about the ability to control a game, is not necessarily just scoring.
And he does it like this. See the foot speed, JB? He's got quick feet, able to slap that ball up the floor. Anticipation.
So you're talking more about the feet as opposed to the hands. Yeah,
he understands where to be and explodes after the basketball.
Good aggressive defense by Cal.
Yeah, the 2-3 zone effective. I don't think Adonis could have gotten that if he was Michael Jordan. The kick out.
Or another Kansas 11. Wilt Chamberlain as Roy Williams looking on.
Roy down there with Dean and Bill Guthridge. I know Dean had to pick up the check with those two. They wouldn't go for a free lunch, those gentlemen. And here's the little nickel dimer by
and
Jordan.
It's called on Jordan, and Jordan is asking, my goodness, Mr. Ref, you're right on top of it. We get it from all the way on the other side of the floor.
Well, they like to test the P and the whistle on occasion, and he's up and rattling, but nothing to endanger even that kid.
You're right, nothing major there at all. Kid.
That is going to get better, that stroke. He's confident and a lot of work on it. Plays with those pros out there in the summer. Mentioned Chris Mullen told him a lot about defense. I know Luke Connors second to get a kick out of that. His
wow.
Former coach at St. John's.
You certainly wouldn't think that.
He can make that. Got to get up on him. Irk Pauly.
Pauly's got range back to about 18 to 20 feet, and he nails that one. Kansas 29-27 over Cal. 5:40 left in the first half of play.
Now watch the backs of the white shirts. They'll all get in front of the next logical passer or step in front.
And Jordan, with the help out that time, creating the walk of Lamond Murray.
We've talked about the steals and the ability to pass and find people. I mentioned today he's a Bob Hurley with 4 inches. He's got a heart, a winner, a guy that understands how to defeat people.
Bobby Hurley with 4 inches?
Yeah,
boy,
well, he's a,
that's dangerous.
And strong. So he's a point guy, same position, and a wonderful field. 1-1-3.
Jordan, Hancock, Pauly, Rex Walters, and Richard Scott, the 5 in white for Kansas.
And it's a 1-3-1 now. And the reason would be to stop running after Kansas. They tire you much like Indiana does. force the outside shot, maybe a mistake. They got a turnover earlier on a cross-court pass. Problem is rebounding underneath.
Jordan for three. Adonis Jordan with the rainbow shot, and Jordan's got eight. Jayhawks out in front by five.
And here's the double up of the pick and roll. It forces the ball into other people's hands.
KJ Roberts, ugly.
He's got some speed, doesn't he? Mm-hmm.
Foul before the shot.
A lot of ways of playing the pick and roll. You can string it out, you can double, this time forcing the cross-court kick and a rather unattractive delivery, a scraper. And generally, that ignites a break.
And Todd Bozeman's got a decision here as Jason Kidd has picked up his second personal foul. 4:35 left in the first half of play. Do you leave him in or do you bench him?
Well, you find out how much confidence he has, and he attacks the dribble as they get the pick. Eric Pauly, the giveaway, a very helpful play for Cal.
And that foul called on Pauly, first personal on Pauly.
Now, this is part of learning the game. Even for a youngster that understands as much, why go out there? He's not going to score. Scott, particularly, who's a box area player, stay back.
16 fouls on Kansas, 4 on the Bears.
Nice job out here defensively by Jordan.
And a good rebound by Kansas, blocking out nicely.
Oh!
Nice pass. And Scott is hammered. He'll take a trip to the free throw line.
Grigsby gives it up at the end, but I was surprised Darren Hancock was able to stop and make that pass in full roll. Able to find Scott.
Grigsby with two. And at the free throw line, Richard Scott.
Now both clubs get the big guys down the floor. That's what enabled Scott to get in position in that dilemma area. When you post up in the 3-second lane, you just don't know how to guard a guy.
And I'll tell you, the fact that Scott made the free throw is big indeed. He struggled at the free throw line throughout his career. Was a 38% free throw shooter last season. Now he's at 49%.
Well, you get the hands up. He gives you a facial if you don't.
And he's at the average, 1 of 2 at the free throw line. 33-27, Kansas. Pauly. Once Scott has a hand on it and saves it.
Getting it to the box too easily.
Jordan. You would never know Adonis Jordan is playing in pain.
They're rattling them.
Hendrick. Nice strong move by Hendrick, who was fouled.
Terrific look. The defense extraordinary as they've attacked Kansas, taking Cal out of their sets. Just a beautiful pass at the end here, and the finish by Hendrick. His daddy'd be awful proud.
That he would. The 6'9 senior center out of Diamond Bay, California, had a dislocated kneecap that he suffered last February. Long rehab process, and actually had arthroscopic surgery, but that to remove the bone chips.
And Hendrick, four-time All-Conference, tying Todd Lichty from Stanford. So he's been doing it for quite a while.
Good company, and what looked to have been a clean block whistled as a foul instead on Pauly. Is that correct? And it is, in fact, on Pauly, second personal. Lamond Murray at the free throw line, and Jason Kidd was effusive in the praise about him as we talk about the lineup coming your way tomorrow. North Carolina and Arkansas. That ought to be a nice battle. As we take a look out west, Michigan, George Washington, Vanderbilt, and Temple. John Chaney really has that team playing well, and so many guys, players have talked about Aaron McKee as one whale of an offensive
player. Sure, Eddie Jones as well. It's a good basketball team. Rick Brunson, another guy. Three around two. The two post guys bang and pick and let the others go one-on-one.
Pretty. Woodbury to Pauly. Nice movement without the ball by
sure
Pauly.
Was. Nice understanding going to the goal.
37-29, Kansas on top. 3 minutes to play in the first half.
And see how they're shutting off the passing lanes. A rattled Cal offense. Kidd being face guarded, unable to touch it enough for Cal.
Murray. Good hustle by Hendrick, who went down. And he was fouled.
May have been Woodbury running under him. Kidd may have to play down on the box to get him a bump to free him. Once he gives the basketball up, he can't get it back. Rafer doing an excellent job earlier. Adonis Jordan and Todd addressing that problem with him, I'm sure.
Hendrick connecting. I talked about the dislocated kneecap that Hendrick suffered as we take a look at Bozeman communicating with Jason Kidd. The players say that Brian Hendrick, two different players from the first half of the season to the second half of the season, as he continued along that long rehab road and has been playing superb basketball down the stretch. Short, back to Hendrick. Nice pass and connected. Lamond Murray.
They are very good rebounding off of missed free throws, even though that one was a slap back. Do a nice job pinning their guys under the 10.
That cut the Jayhawks lead to 5, and Hendrick will be coming over the back for the foul as Eric Pauly will take a trip to the free throw line. Second personal on Brian Hendrick.
Now, in your heyday, you cleared a few people out as they step across the lane. This is what we talk about, the secondary break. This time they hit the baseline. Occasionally they'll go out top directly, and here's the step across, and Pauly able to catch, lock, and convert. Pretty play. James Brown, since February 1st, Calvin Rafer's had 24 assists and 5 turnovers. His most important contribution tonight is taking the kid out of his game. The 9 fronting. Here's the assist by Walters at the end, but causing others to make decisions. That's not Cal's game.
Right now, it's the Jayhawks game. On top by 5 with 2:25 left in the first half.
They went to 1-3-1 and a little more of a 2-3 look, or a 1-1-3.
And the reason you think?
Well, I think they want to force the outside. They feel they can't control the inside people. They've done a terrific job on their man-to-man, but this guy lights it up. You're going to have to come out and tag him.
Jason Kidd with the rebound. Ahead to Lamond Murray. All he needs is a second, and he'll convert. 16 for Murray. Pauly with the miss. Woodbury with the rebound and follow. The miss. Hendrick with the rebound.
And Todd's got the zone. It's been effective.
Jared Haas for 3. Right back in it.
He gives it up on time. You're free, you get it.
Cal has retaken the lead by 1 with 1:30 left in a half.
And this time they're man-to-man.
Richie. Boy, back and forth.
He drags the center or the big forward out. He's got deeper range than Pauly.
Pass off the mark. Down low on the blocks. Can't get the drop. Rebounded by Murray. Oh, nice pass by Kidd. And Hendrick converts. Billy, I was just about to say how Kidd still sees the entire floor no matter what.
Watch out, Joe Montana. There's another passer in the Bay Area. He searches out, sneaks a peek, and gets it to people.
Jayhawks holding for the last shot of the half. Tie ball game. Walters double clutches. And we have the 7th lead change of the first half, and the foul is called on Grigsby.
There are more than one kid in this game. Jason on the money with this look, and we talked about hearts pumping and ticking at the other end. Rex, the double clutch and the affectionate kiss at the end. And you know what I love about Rex? He's got a great perception or evaluation of talent. We mentioned Mike Francesa and his basketball ability. He's going to challenge him to horse. Somebody's going to have to get the rebound for Michael O.
Well, I'm sure Mike will have something to say about that. Rex Walters, 5 of 6 from the floor. Kansas on top, 43-40, 2.2 left in the half. Ahead to Kidd. Oh. Kidd, quick pass to Hess. And Murray nearly executed. And boy, is that a good highlight to run to show how much you can do with 2.2 seconds, but not converted. So Kansas will hold on to a 3-point lead at the half.
Well, this is caring, understanding the game, avoiding the charge. That's the contagious play that Kidd brings to the floor. Beautiful play.
So that's the end of the first half with the score. Kansas on top of Cal by 3. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Semifinal Game is sponsored by Oldsmobile, official car for NCAA Championships. UPS, the package delivery company more companies count on. And by AT&T, the right choice.
Leslie Visser.
JB, the Kansas coaches are disappointed they let an 8-point lead slip. Offensively, they've got to move the ball better and also start hitting the offensive boards. They gave up a couple of rebounds on their own missed free throws. Defensively, they told Adonis Jordan to simply keep Jason Kidd in front of him. They said that if he turns the corner, he makes everybody better. JB.
And there's no question about that, Leslie. And back here, Coach, your thoughts about the first half?
Well, I think the Lamond Murray was very important in terms of getting the 3-point shot or getting inside. You'll see he had opportunities down low. He'll get himself free. They'll find him. It's a question of can Paulie continue to get the opportunities down on the box. He got some terrific position baskets. He even made one out by the foul line, which you noted as ability to shoot outside. And I think that caused Cal to go zone.
And the one other thing that shot chart pointed out is that Cal running very much a left-handed offense. The shots coming principally on the left. Jordan, Scott, Hancock, Walters, and Paulie, the 5 on the floor. Just underway here in the second half. Kansas on top of Cal by 3, and Scott making that move down low actually caught Grigsby with an elbow across the face, but the foul is called on Grigsby, and that's 4. And Bill, Grigsby certainly didn't help matters at all in the first half, saddled with 3 personal fouls and no points. He averages 10 on the season.
And he gets caught behind, which we've seen frequently of the Cal team, getting there late, giving up that box position. It's so valuable, and you become vulnerable if you permit the ball to come in there.
Heading out is Grigsby, and in is Monty Buckley for California. We talked about this Cal team being young. 6 sophomores, 3 freshmen dominate the roster.
And Buckley, quick defensive reaction. They go zone on the inbounds. I think Cal, when they get on offense, has to relax a little bit. They don't have the fast break control.
Nice look by Walters, and an injury on the floor. And Hancock is still down on the floor. Roberts on the score after the pass, but Hancock in pain after that shot attempt.
He's had his share of difficulties physically. The 2 detached retinas, what was the Colorado game?
All in separate, the same game.
Separate instances. And here's his penetration, undoubtedly thrown off balance and either buckling on its own or on a foot. And having played, as most people watching have at some point, that's just a very scary feeling. Not sure as you come down on the left whether you're stable enough to get up and maneuver.
and gingerly leaving the court. And just to elaborate, as Bill mentioned, although the injury here is to the leg, Hancock had both retinas torn in the same game against Colorado. Two separate incidents. And Hancock wears the goggles as a result, although he didn't have the goggles on the first game back.
And he had double game. And he had the double figures that he hasn't had them since.
Not so since.
The glasses haven't been an asset.
43-42, Kansas on top. 19 minutes left in the ball game. The winner advances to meet Indiana, a top seed here in the Midwest in the regional final on Saturday, and a 5-second call. Good defense by California.
And Roberts in particular, as well as Kidd, denying the return pass. And there's that comparison. Walters able to stroke, having a terrific first half. Kidd, I think, has got to think of some offense.
And just to expand on those numbers, Kansas backcourt outscored the backcourt of Cal 23-7 in the first half.
And as Leslie said, look at Jordan denying the ball to Kidd. And a turnover because of the aggressive defense, Scott particularly.
And as I mentioned, what's at stake here? A trip to the Midwest Regional Final on Saturday right here at the St. Louis Arena to meet top-seeded Indiana. On the turnover, it's Kansas ball. I tell you what, Bill, Rex Walters and Adonis Jordan really have risen to the challenge by virtue of their first half performance. Looking forward to this battle with Jason Kidd and company. Nice jump hook by Pauling.
Now, JB, there's good defense on Adonis Jordan, but the post guy's wide open. You've got to complement the aggressive defense outside.
And the aggressive backcourt defense doing a job in limiting the effectiveness of Jason Kidd. Good defense by Murray. Here comes Kidd.
Look at this speed and strength.
And the follow by Murray.
Kidd should have been on the foul line, but great effort to make sure.
Still a one-point ball game and a foul underneath here. It looks like it'll be on Brian Hendrick. That will be three if it is.
When you're built like this, and you can relate, I certainly can't, people don't expect you to be as fast. Now, Walters can scoot with the best of them. He still gets it up. The compliment paid by Cal on the follow. But he should have been at the foul line.
I agree. California has fought its way into the Sweet 16, a team that was 10-7 back on February 8th, the midseason firing of Lou Campanelli. They've gone 11-1 since. Nice break and the slam by Buckley.
Buckley to the bucket. Who saved it? Kidd. They can turn from defense to offense with the best teams in the country. This is a tough backcourt, and they're being tested because of the tenacious defense by Cal.
And Kidd is going to be called for the foul, trying to stop Rex Walters. It'll be three on Jason Kidd.
That's a case of backing off when you know you have two. They need him to hang in and win this game. They can't play without him.
And Kidd looks over at Todd Bozeman and gives him the eye contact saying, I can stay in, coach.
We've heard that before, too.
Have we not?
And Walter's testing him in a way.
A lot of time left, too, Bill. 17 minutes.
He's so experienced, Rex, that knows how far he can take a guy.
Walters. Here's a kid, Rex Walters, who routinely comes in the gym 2 hours before and is 2 hours after everyone leaving, working on his game.
If he comes to your carnival, folks, close that basketball shooting stand.
Jason Kidd answering the challenge back. Kidd has a total of six. And another potential injury down here on the opposite end of the floor. Richard Scott still down on the floor.
At first, I thought it was the ankle. Then I thought it may have been a cramp.
That's what I was thinking, a cramp.
And getting into the middle once again. Just think of when he starts shooting the ball from outside. You've got to play him honest for the deep shot. Either hand, whatever you need. We mentioned the strength, JB. That shoulder, like a great running back, wards off the defender and finishes.
And the legs that you talked about, the strong legs. 8 ties in a ball game. 16-19 left in the contest. Nice pass to Jordan, blocked by KJ Roberts. Nice pass to Woodbury, blocked by Murray. And ahead to Roberts. The numbers 3-on-2. Buckley can't score. Kidd with the loose ball. Scores and is fouled.
Mike Krzyzewski, get onto the couch. You'll remember the shot at the end. But first, it's the interior defense responding, assisting, as Jordan up amongst the big fellas, gives it up to Woodbury, and at the other end, another one of those kid kisses.
I love it when you get excited, Bill.
Some guys just light up a building, and he's certainly going to be one of them for a long time to come.
Paulie can't light it up from the outside. Here comes Kidd, 1-on-4. His trailer's finally caught up. Murray. And Murray with the penetration and is fouled. He'll take a trip to the free throw line. The foul is on Paulie, and that is 4 on Eric Paulie. So Greg Ostertag will come in as well as Calvin Rayford to give Adonis Jordan a break.
Now Kansas has to address misses and balance, transition back to defense. Cal, when that happens, has to readjust. If they don't get the break, show some semblance of order. Don't rush into things. That's what got them in the hole in the first half. Control.
Now, when you say address it, you mean?
As you come up the floor and you don't see it, back it off, run your sets. And they will be tested. You know, inexperienced coach, inexperienced team against a seasoned club that's been to the wars before.
And Murray drops it in. Well, Todd Bozeman has shown in his short time that he can coach with the best of them.
Back in St. Louis at the arena, the Kansas Jayhawks might be renamed My Left Foot. Two players suffered slightly sprained left ankles, Darren Hancock and Richard Scott. Trainer Mark Caron said that Richard Scott is likely to return. He doesn't know about Hancock. JB?
All right, Leslie, and Bill, that brings up the point. In practice sessions, you may see athletes doing some weird things like walking on the outer soles and on the inner soles, and that's to try to stretch, make them a bit more resilient.
Stretch the ligaments, and Darren Hancock's in on cue.
And the foul will be called on Ryan Jameson as Patrick Ritchie will take a trip to the free throw line.
Well, one of the reasons people love basketball is when great performers step up to a high level and understand where they are on the floor. And Mike Krzyzewski, oh, does that hurt? I know. He's got some releases, doesn't he?
And an arsenal. More than just shots. Nice release by Richie.
Now, KU's a team that relishes defense. They get the opportunities, create some enthusiasm off the defensive end. They've got to force Cal into some rushes or turnovers.
1 of 2 for Richie. 52-49, Bears on top. Murray for 3. Rebounded by Jameson, knocked out of bounds by Kansas. Richard Scott trying to walk off the Charlie horse.
Mm-hmm. A little post up, first time this game. They get it home. So if you're not used to doing it on a regular basis, it can throw you out of kilter.
You're right. He's usually initiating the play from out high.
He doesn't want for dinner companions. He sets the table. Inside, they did damage early. Kansas has to get back into it and then kick it out. Well, Richie, the reverse guy, can make that top of the key jumper.
Hancock and Bill, good patience by Kansas on the offensive end and get a high percentage shot.
Great understanding that trip. You kick it over once or twice, generally defense softens.
Two very well-coached teams. Kidd. And you're right, that's what he has to work on.
That will come.
Woodbury looking to give Kansas the lead. And he does. Score the basket, and he's fouled.
He's the action. Jayhawk. Whether it's the jumper or the ability to turn the corner, he's some weapon as he releases that kiss rather high off the glass. A lot of people to turn to, and they're all ready. You notice with KU, everybody's got the sneakers tied.
Mm-hmm, tight.
Sweatpants off. They sell a lot of programs.
What about Woodbury? Roy Williams says he is the best defensive player I have coached in terms of a guy playing defense the entire game. And Woodbury is going to take a seat and rest.
Coaches are superstitious, but how about Roy? Going to the cemeteries of James Naismith and Fog Allen, tapping, and people said Kansas's team was dead. They weren't playing well. He said, I didn't see my team there. I just said hello to the old great coaches and moved on. I figured we had a run in the NCAA.
And shared it with his guys, and I'm sure they were probably scratching their heads as well. You talk about superstition. Back in 82, when Roy Williams was an assistant on Dean Smith's championship team, he thought back when he spit in the Mississippi, so he took his entire team yesterday and they spit in the Mississippi. ...18-5 on hand here at the St. Louis Arena, watching the battle between the number 6 seed California and the number 2 seed Kansas. Kansas on top by 2, 13-33 remaining. The winner advances to the Midwest Regional Final on Saturday against the top seed, Indiana.
And JB, the 2-3 on the out-of-bounds, they got to attack people. Don't let the outside shooters set up.
Hancock has a strip by Hendrick. This is Kidd.
He threw a skimmer. A dummy play. The defense turned and yet catchable.
And the foul called on Hendrick. That's the 17th foul on the Bears. It'll be 1-1 for KU.
KU is relentless. This is excitement. The defense blind. He understood it. They don't convert, but it was worth another look.
Can't get any closer to that. In and out.
In a situation like this, a team wins. By that, Kidd, when he's not in the play, Cal has some problems. So KU has been able to take him out in some of the offensive half-court sets. And KU relentless. Trying to get it in low, step into the shooting area.
And the foul called on Rex Walters. That'll be the second on Rex. Only the third team foul on Kansas. Brendan Graves in the lineup now for Cal. Kidd, Johnson, Jared Haas, Graves, and Murray, the five in blue for the Cal Bears. Nice hands by Ritchie.
And we'll shut off the next pass. Great job.
And better hands by Hancock. Boy, talk about three plays with great hands. Jared Haas finishes it up with the strip.
You could see it coming at half court. They'll then shut off when you close down the passer.
Started in the backcourt with Jason Kidd. Went through some emotional difficulties, Jared Haas, when he lost his father in January. Slip in play, but certainly has come back strong the last five or six ball games. And although he doesn't start for the team anymore, he gets starters minutes with 18. This is Walter.
You gotta know his number. You have to get out on him.
Well, the number he has right now, 19. Scott. Foul, Johnson.
Kansas, a 79% shooting team from the free throw line, but with their zone defense, Cal has not addressed the ability to stroke from deep. You got to get out and play him, JB. We know who he is. They have to know.
The top seed here in the Midwest Regional has already advanced to the regional final game on Saturday. awaiting the winner of this contest between California and Kansas. And Rex Walters at the free throw line. And Walters has certainly had himself a sensational game up to this point. He's got 20 points in the contest.
And JB, he wasn't heavily recruited out of high school. Said he would have gone to Cal if they paid attention to him. Went to Northwestern and saw Kansas in the NIT preseason and thought it might be a nice place to go to get a chance to play in the NCAA.
An 11-0 KU run, and the Jayhawks on top by 7, 59-52, 12 minutes left in the ball game.
And Todd Bozeman with a good move, trying to get his club organized. This is the end. I think they've got to show a degree of intelligence. Don't rush into it. Get a good one.
He had tried to squeeze it in traffic.
Todd being forced to come back with Grigsby, who's saddled with the foul problems.
Kid can get it. Woodbury saves it inbounds. This is Jordan.
He's had some good opportunities, hasn't been able to convert them. Offense, good call. Richard Scott with a clear out. Now in the schoolyard, guys would say, heck of a pick. And it was. I mean, I liked it.
Heck of a set of eyes on you, the coach, still.
Pretty little clear out, unfortunately, against the rules.
Murray off of the double pick. Boy, defensively, Kansas really challenges every shot. Here comes Hancock.
Didn't need it, really. What? Oh, they're going to say kid was out of bounds, but that was cute.
And quick.
How did they get so smart so young?
My goodness, it's in the food.
And there's an excellent young coach, Todd Bozeman. The team has really rallied around Bozeman, having won 8 straight, 11 of 12 since Bozeman has taken over. Woodbury, deep. Kidd. Splits the defenders and scores. Count it. He'll take a trip to the free throw line.
Touchdown, California. He can go by people, both with speed and strength. Always looking, prying, the ability to use both hands. Loves the right hand more than the left at this stage in his career. The scrape and completion by a great one.
Kidd with 11 points, 2 away from his season's average. And Cal trailing the Jayhawks by 4, 10:38 left in the ball game. Everyone's talked about the good season, second half of the season of Cal. The players say, we don't just want to be here. We want to win it. Mm-hmm. We think we can.
And it's starting to attack the shooters. They get out on Rex Walters. That's one way of doing it. This could help Cal if they don't get out.
Jordan off the back of the iron, rebounded by Walters. Kidd disrupting the play, but a fresh 45 for KU. Nice pass inside, but Scott couldn't control.
Scott had been wide open for quite a while.
Murray wide open. Rebounded by Jordan.
Nice
pass. This time Scott controls and is fouled.
You are seeing some pretty fair basketball on both ends.
No question about it. Cal doing a good job of getting back defensively.
And then the screen off, ceiling down low, and Woodbury right on the correct hand. Good sound basketball.
And as an ex-coach, you can appreciate that.
Well, with not this type of kid, I might add. We had a few, but not the numbers they have out here.
Scott drops in the first. You know, they seemingly have all kinds of all teams in the Big 8. Richard Scott, as we take a look at Murray taking a seat on the bench in Buckley, and Richard Scott made the Big 8 all underrated team.
Mm-hmm.
Darren Hancock made the Big Eight all newcomer team.
Well, I can be late to the underrated. And you've been around a long time. You can't be a newcomer.
Tell me about it.
You know what's great about Kansas? The more you watch them, when you pull the switch, the plug, change defenses, they react easily. It's not a flustered team. They understand what they have to do to get in position. Here's the 1-3-1. First time all game.
And to put a period on your point there, that's good coaching.
And right here, you might see an opportunity to get an alley-oop. Or right here, the elbow jumper.
Buckley. Monty Buckley, the sophomore out of Sacramento, California, averaging 4 points, drops in a big one.
I see Kansas will stay with it. A little change of pace shown by Roy Williams at the other end. When it's ineffective, guys like to get out of it.
Good hustle by Richie. Ostertag posting low. Back out to Jordan. And Jordan for three.
When they went in early in the first half, that's how they got their lead, whether it was the big guy finishing or the kick out.
32 points for the backcourt of Kansas, Jordan and Walters. Buckley for three. Ostertag with the rebound. A 6-point KU lead, 8:38 left in the game. Indiana awaiting the winner here for the Midwest Regional Final. Walters.
Staying alive. He didn't stay in the wing. Good, strong cut. And then the response.
Jared Hass. And Richie with the rebound. Here come the Jayhawks.
Very tough period right now for Cal.
And the foul called on Jared Hass.
Hass doesn't get there. Here's the replay, JB, of inside and out basketball at its best. And that's been effective, particularly in the first half. Hear the curl around the foul line off a bump, the response. And Walters with that high release.
What kind of release, Bill?
High kiss release. They just
go ahead.
Continue their motion on offense, and that makes them tough to defend.
Send it the other way. Now you're going to Owens home.
Second personal on Hass. Woodbury at the free throw line. Cal with 10 team fouls makes it the double bonus situation for Kansas.
They put the fist up just like Carolina when they want to come out. You know how Dean has the players when you're 15? Not too many guys in my neighborhood would put the fist up.
Where would they go?
Tag the big body controlling the rebound. He's got five. Boy, your point's well taken. Constant movement on offense by Kansas. And we talked in the first game about how that can tire you out defensively.
And then it hurts you at the other end. Yeah, very like Indiana.
Good control of the pass first by Hancock and the score. 70-58, the Jayhawks using a 22-6 run.
Watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Kansas on top, 70-58, 7:02 left in the ball game, and the Jayhawks looking to try to keep the Bears on the ropes.
Cal has to establish some inside game right now, JB. Let the guys try to come out of a stack offense.
Hendrick
so much for that philosophy, but it goes down anyhow. Jordan doing a great job not letting Kidd get the ball back. Oh. Gorgeous delivery.
Mm-hmm.
Double zero, strong to the tin.
Hendrick working hard, second straight basket as Hendrick has dropped in 11.
James, they're trying to pressure a little bit. They got to get something on this end, whether it's a tough shot, a pinch, and a turnover. When you're denying like this, they get their alley-oops out of their back screens. You're very aggressive. They'll pull a string.
A 10-point Kansas lead, 5:50 left in the ball game. Inside to Ostertag. A line drive. He needs more arc.
Yeah,
he's not
getting it up. He did that in the first half.
Rigsby with the rebound. This is Kidd with the ball. Cal trying to cut into the lead. Cut it under 10. Pass. Strong rebound by Murray. A fresh 45 for Cal. And it goes the other way. Adonis Jordan doing Roy Williams' job of keeping Kidd in front of him. And Bozeman recognizes it. Kansas putting together a 24-10 run. Still shooting well while Cal is not here in the second half. And Walters has been averaging 25 points per game in the three NCAA tournament games thus far. Rayford, Woodbury, Hancock, Ritchie, and Ostertag, the five in white for Kansas on the floor. Patient on the offensive end.
You got to make sure you don't foul and rebound if you're Cal. And if you're Kansas, you want to get something either on the peninsula. So much for that. The jumper.
It was on the rim, but not called. Woodbury gets the tap in. 72-62 back. Make it 74-62. Kansas on top with 4:30 left in the ball game.
Again, they double the dribbler.
Hendrick.
It's a little more effective with him out there screening on the pick and roll.
Hendrick doing his best. Six straight field goals. Back to 10. Time becoming a big factor as California will have to do something to step it up.
Kidd not playing Rayford at all. Now they switch. He's staying in the zone.
And Roy Williams having done a nice job of keeping fresh players on the floor to keep that motion offense going, Bill.
Well, and they're down to 8 seconds, and the last trip they got a tip in, so you've got a rebound if there's a miss if you're counting.
And Rayford with the dividend.
I can shoot with the big guys.
And Hendrick, seven straight field goals for Brian Hendrick.
They got a nice spot here to get the reach in on Kidd. Grigsby was set to steal the pass out by the foul area.
Well, Jason Kidd showing the frustration as he picks up his fourth personal foul. And the packed house here at the St. Louis Arena looking at the Jayhawks holding to a 76-66 lead, 3:17 remaining. The Jayhawks and the Bears fighting to move to Saturday's regional final against the top seed, Hoosiers of Indiana.
It's amazing how this little guy compliments Adonis Jordan. Same up-tempo. Same pressure with the dribble, tenacious defense. So you don't have a switch when you take one or the other out of the game. Great advantage for Kansas.
That's the time remaining in the ball game, and Kansas on top, 78-66. James Brown along with Bill Raftery and Leslie Visser. And Cal will have to use a serious spurt here. And Murray tries to get it started with a three.
That helps them organize.
Well, they had a perfect spot for a trap right there at half court. Good control by Richie.
Woodbury.
See, if you don't take advantage of one, you usually get burnt somewhere.
And Grigsby has it stripped. What a tough evening for Alfred Grigsby, who averages 10 points a game, and he has yet to score.
How about the 3 second lane? The advantage and the strip bails out Richie.
Kidd with the rebound and score.
See if they take advantage of the lines, JB. Here's a perfect trap. Now they can step up. Oh, why the reach in?
Yep, a reaching foul called on Murray.
Lamond. It's so tempting.
And California, well over the 10 foul limit, so two free throws for Kansas.
There's always hope with Murray able to stroke those threes. He hadn't been on fire early in this half. Take a check at the timeouts. Cal at a disadvantage with only one left, but Todd had to use the others to hang in there.
Bet he did. Woodbury, second team all Big Eight for Kansas. And the 6'4 junior drops it in. I guess the best thing to call Woodbury is a fake non-starter.
Mm-hmm. The minutes are extraordinary. Up there with the best of them at 25 a game. Double screen and the switch by Walters.
Roy Williams' team has really done a nice job defensively. We heard Leslie talk about the tactic of keeping Jason Kidd in front all night, and Kansas has done that very well.
See, there's another case of club shooting the threes. Now, I know you want them, but if they come and you can feed off them naturally, that's okay. Nice little strip by Hess. They get the timeout, too.
Well, you like the tenacity that Bozeman's Bears are showing, trailing 82-73. 1:51 remaining. Kansas on top, 82-73. Kansas ball. Richie taking it out of bounds. And Jared Hass fouling Walters to control the clock. And regional semifinal action continues tomorrow. George Washington and Michigan, Virginia and Cincinnati. And the second half of the doubleheader, Arkansas, North Carolina, Temple versus Vanderbilt. It'll all be coming your way tomorrow. Primetime coverage right here on CBS.
You notice the contact on that trap? Walter, every good player, you get a little hand in there. You got to ward off the defender, and Hess gets nailed for it, but a hitty play by Rex Walters. You like the way Jordan defended against Kidd.
I tell you, Walters has done the job scoring, but Adonis Jordan really has done a remarkable job, I think, defensively. Playing in pain, you will never hear from him, and to do the job on Jason Kidd.
And he's the orchestrator, too. The head.
And doesn't look tired. Murray. That stroke doesn't look tired either.
No, he'll keep getting them up.
As he takes another one. In and out. Grigsby finally scores at the 1:32 mark left in the ball game.
Tradition being served, a traditional three-pointer. On the end, and we talked about this stroke early in the game. He's on the tin with every shot other than the one he went awry with, but it's catchable or it's tippable when Murray shoots.
That foul was the fifth on Eric Pauly as he takes a seat. And he leaves with five rebounds along with the 10 points. So Scott, Jordan, Richie, Woodbury, and Walters, the five in white, and Walters loses it off his hands. 83-76, Billy still not over, 1:32 left.
No quit in these Bears. They don't have the timeouts. They utilize the one. They've organized their press after a made goal.
Kansas not really looking up the floor or handling the ball well. Nice bailout by Head. He was going down and out of bounds, threw it off Walter's body.
And Bozeman showing some excellent tactical skills here, staying with it to the very end. Not conceding in the slightest. Pass for the three. And Kidd will be called for the foul as he comes over the back. And for Kidd, if it is on him, that should be five.
Well, this is one kid that will be back in the NCAA. Mm-hmm. A memorable run, and there's the affection for one another. And I think that's what's carried this club at the end of the year.
No doubt about that. And the fans show their appreciation for number five, who leaves with five fouls. Finished with 13 points on the evening. What a tremendous run by this ball club, though. As we mentioned, 10-7 when Bozeman took over on February the 8th. 11-1 down the stretch, eight straight victories. They were 4-5 in Pac-10 play, wound up in second place in the conference. So just a remarkable job done under some very tough circumstances by the young man Todd Bozeman at age 29, the youngest ever to guide a team into the round of 16.
I talked to people out on the coast about Cal. They got the best sophomore, arguably, in Murray, and the best freshman in Kidd. And in the future, as bright as this past month. Marvelous basketball. And it's not only the offense, it's their defense. They feed off it. They relish getting after people.
Well, the son of Ira and Martha Bozeman, I'm sure, has made them very proud.
Well, there'll be no more early morning deliveries by their son.
Referencing the job he had in high school.
His early days of expressing around the neighborhood for deliveries.
Working with Federal Express. Roberts for three. And Jordan again is everywhere. By Buckley as he hammered Hancock. Hancock has really taken a beating this evening.
And he's still ticking, too. He has been banged around, whether it's the foot, this one to the cheek. He can take a punch. We know that. Mm. He doesn't mind getting banged as he's soaring and jamming. They give the intentional foul now. Originally was going to go to Vegas and opted for JC and ended up a Jayhawk.
Well, Billy, with 104 remaining in the ball game, we certainly don't want to say that it's over, but Kansas holding to a 10-point lead. Make it 11, but if it holds up, it really will set up a matchup between the top seed Indiana and the number two seed Kansas. Two squads that look very much alike. What do you see?
If I'm Bobby Knight, I'm sure he'll check with me as to what to do.
Oh, without a doubt, he's got your room number.
He's got to be concerned about the inside people, I think. They've got a good inside game. They pass well from the low box. It might make him stretch his D, eliminate a lot of the help. So that would be my concern if I'm him. A little trip as Woodbury goes to the goal.
Murray picks up his second personal.
The other thing is the transition of Kansas now is another problem. How you get back, they didn't really get the second option from their break very much. Cal well prepared to take it away, which is surprising, I'm sure, to a lot of people.
Roy Williams, who had doubted his own coaching a couple of times publicly, saying that he would have to do a better job, certainly has done an excellent job.
Well, the great ones are always tough on themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Both teams very similar when we get into the Indiana and Kansas matchup. They tire the opponent down with bumps and screens and cuts and make you pay attention to business.
Well, I tell you, Roy Williams certainly looks in marvelous shape, but you can relate to that. The both of you are.
For different reasons.
Tomorrow night, North Carolina and Arkansas. It'll be the quickness and speed of Arkansas against the size of North Carolina. And then you take a look out west, George Washington, and they are a Cinderella team. Number 12 seed still alive. Al McGuire says he thinks You only become a Cinderella when you're in the Elite Eight. Well, I think a 12 seed in the round of 16 qualifies as a Cinderella.
Well, Al's got his reasons.
Oh, I'm sure.
I'm sure he's met a lot of Cinderellas in his day.
Oh, my goodness.
But you got to think of the tough-mindedness of Indiana to finish our conversation with the next game. I mean, these kids are as strong-willed as I've seen. They put together a great run at the end of the year. Without Allen Henderson, still very tough to beat. So you are going to have a tough task if you're Kansas. They guard as well at Indiana.
No question about it. Hancock hammered by Murray. No foul call. Scott can't get it, but stays with it and gets it. Whoa. And that'll do it as Kansas uses a 10-0 run to close the game as Roy Williams and Todd Bozeman shake hands. So the top two seeds in the Midwest Regional will meet in a regional final on Saturday right here at the St. Louis Arena. Jason Kidd congratulating some guys he saw when he was a freshman in high school, Walters and Jordan. So the final score, Kansas wins at 93-76. The Jayhawks will meet Indiana on Saturday in the regional final right here at the St. Louis Arena. The MVPs, Jason Kidd of California, Rex Walters of Kansas. So for Bill Raftery and Leslie Visser, I'm James Brown saying so long from the St. Louis Arena. And we now take you from St. Louis back to New York and Pat O'Brien.
All right, JB, good job, good game. Kansas advances to the Elite Eight after being an early exit last year, Mike.
And they wore them down second half, took charge, were able to make California chase them late in the game. And Kansas beat Indiana earlier this year in Hoosier Dome, so we got a little rematch.
Here's a game Bobby Knight wants.
And Bobby Knight's been waiting for this rematch because they were embarrassed losing to 45,000 in the Hoosier Dome, and it came down to foul shooting the last 2 minutes. That's why Indiana lost.
Bobby doesn't mind those losses, does he? Huh? So it'll be Kansas, Indiana. Let's get everybody set on what's going to happen tomorrow night here on CBS and show you our menu of coverage. At 8 o'clock, George Washington, Yinkadari, up against the Fab Five sophomores of Michigan. Some coverage begins at 7:30 with Virginia and Cincinnati, a sleeper team in a lot of people's brackets there, Cincinnati. And then in our second tier of games tomorrow night, we'll look at Arkansas, Bill Clinton's team, against North Carolina, and Temple and Vanderbilt. And Mike Francesa, you like Temple. You still got Temple in your brackets.
Yeah, right? They're still hanging in there, and they match up. It's interesting. Temple's matchup zone against the shooting and passing and the very cerebral play of Vanderbilt. Very good matchup.
All right, we're going to take you out to Charlotte. That game is still underway. A little bit. And savory. Introduce.